Good morning, students. Let's continue with our lesson, Forest and Wildlife Resources. Before I continue, I want you all to take out your books and pen so that you can jot down some important points. Let's start. Asiatic cheetah. Students, already we have learnt about Asiatic cheetah in the previous video. In this video, we are going to learn about this animal in detail. Asiatic cheetah is the world's fastest land mammal, unique and specialized member of the cat family. It can move at the speed of 112 km per hour. Prior to the 20th century, cheetahs were widely distributed throughout Africa and Asia. So I hope you would have understood, students. Asiatic cheetah is the world's fastest land mammal. It belongs to the cat family. It can move at the speed of 112 km per hour. And prior to the 20th century, Asiatic cheetahs were widely distributed throughout Africa and Asia. You can see the image of Asiatic cheetah over here. And in 1952, it was declared extinct in our country. I had already explained this in the previous video. Today, the Asian or the Asiatic cheetah is nearly extinct due to a decline of available habitat and prey. So what's the reason behind the extinction of Asiatic cheetah? Yes, it's due to the decline of available habitat. Habitat means the natural environment in which particular species of organism live. And what about prey, students? It's animal or bird that is killed and eaten by another animal or bird. So what's the reason behind the extinction of Asian or Asiatic cheetah? Yes, it's due to the decline of the available habitat and prey. The species was declared extinct in India long back in 1952. This I have already explained to you, students. Now let's try to find out the answer for this question. What are the negative factors that cause such fearful depletion of the flora and fauna? Flora means plants, fauna means animals. So let's try to find out, okay, the causes, the reasons for the depletion of plants and animals, that is flora and fauna. We have transformed nature into a resource obtaining directly and indirectly from the forest and wildlife. Students, if we look around, okay, we will come to know that it is we ourselves who have transformed the nature into resource obtaining directly and indirectly from the forest and wildlife. For example, wood, bark, leaves, rubber, medicines, dyes, food, fuel, fodder, manure, etc. So many things we are obtaining from forest and wildlife, right? So it's very clear, students, that it is we ourselves who have depleted our forest and wildlife. Okay, so I hope you have understood this. It's we ourselves who have depleted our forest and wildlife. In colonial period, that is the British rule, during British rule, the expansion of railways, agriculture, commercial and scientific forestry as well as mining activity has led to the depletion of flora. Okay, over exploitation of forest resources took place during colonial period. Vast stretches of forest areas were cleared for expansion of railways. Okay, students, so expansion of railways, agriculture, commercial and scientific forestry. Commercial forestry means trees for commercial purposes like furniture, buildings, etc. And scientific forestry, wherein one particular type of tree is planted in straight rows. Okay, so during British rule, due to expansion of railways, agriculture, commercial and scientific forestry and mining activity, depletion of flora took place. Okay, not only in colonial period, but also after independence. After independence, expansions of agriculture continues to be one of the cause of depletion of forest resources. So it's very clear, students, not only during British rule but after independence also, due to expansions of agriculture, okay, has led to the depletion of forest resources. I hope it's clear, students. Between 1951 and 1980, according to the Forest Survey of India, over 26,200 square kilometers of forest was converted to agricultural land all over India. So you need to remember this figure, right? Between 1951 and 1980, according to the Forest Survey of India, over 26,200 square kilometers of forest was converted to agricultural land all over India. Substantial parts of the tribal belts in the northeastern and central India have been deforested by shifting cultivation, that is also known as zoom cultivation, a type of slash and burn agriculture. So I will explain this shifting cultivation now. Okay, students, here the farmers, what do they do is they clear the piece of forest land by burning the trees. Okay, that adds potash to the soil, which is very fertile, okay, which is very favorable for the cultivation of crops. And then after, when the fertility of the soil decreases, the farmers leave this land and then they move on to the next area, the next piece of land of the forest. So I hope it's very clear, students. You have understood about shifting cultivation. I've already explained this in geography lesson number one. Okay. Next is, are colonial forest policies to be blamed? Some of the environmental activists say that the promotion of a few favored species in many parts of India has been carried through the ironically termed enrichment plantation. Now, what is this enrichment plantation, students? Enrichment plantation in which a single commercially valuable species extensively planted and other species are eliminated. I hope it's clear, students, once again. Single commercially valuable species extensively planted, wherein the other species are eliminated. Like teak monoculture. Mono means single. Okay, monoculture means wherein single crop is grown in an area. So teak monoculture has damaged the natural forest in South India, and cheer pine plantations in the Himalayas have replaced the Himalayan oak and rhododendron forest. So here we can see that teak monoculture, the plantation of teak, okay, has damaged the natural forest in South India, whereas cheer pine plantations in the Himalayas have replaced the Himalayan oak and rhododendron forest. I will be showing you the images now. This is the image of cheer pine, okay, oak tree, rhododendron. Okay, students, now let's proceed further. Large-scale development projects have also contributed significantly to the loss of forest. So large-scale development projects have also, they are also the reason for the loss of forest. Since 1951, over 50,000 square kilometers of forest was cleared for river valley projects. I want you all to remember this figure, students. Since 1951, over 50,000 square kilometer of forest was cleared. For what? Yes, for river valley projects. Clearing of forest is still continuing with projects like the Narmada Sagar project in Madhya Pradesh, which would inundate 40,000 hectares of forest. Inundate means to cover an area of land with water. So clearing of forest is still continuing. Okay, it has not stopped. It's still continuing with projects like Narmada Sagar project in Madhya Pradesh, which would inundate 40,000 hectares of forest. That means 40,000 hectares of forest would be under water. Okay, so you can see the clearing of forest here for the Narmada Sagar project. Mining is another important factor behind deforestation. So mining is also one of the important factor behind deforestation. The forest has been cleared for mining purpose. Example, the Buxar Tiger Reserve. You can see the image of Buxar Tiger Reserve here. The Buxar Tiger Reserve in West Bengal is threatened by the ongoing dolomite mining. Dolomite is a mineral. So Buxar Tiger Reserve in West Bengal is threatened by because of the dolomite mining, which has disturbed the natural habitat of many species and blocked the migration route of several others, including the great Indian elephant. So here you can see due to dolomite mining, Buxar Tiger Reserve in West Bengal is threatened. Okay, and it has disturbed, this mining has disturbed the natural habitat of many species over here. And not only this, it has blocked the migration route of several other species, okay, including the great Indian elephant. Let's see the images now. Buxar Tiger Reserve. This is the dolomite. Here is the image of great Indian elephant. Okay. So once again we will revise this, students. The Buxar Tiger Reserve in West Bengal is threatened by the ongoing dolomite mining, which has disturbed the natural habitat of many species and blocked the migration route of several others, including the great Indian elephant. Here is the image of great Indian elephant. Let's move further now. Grazing. Students, grazing is also one of the factor for the deforestation. Fuel wood collection. Now, wood collection is also the another factor for deforestation, students. Now, can you tell me the difference between lopping and felling entire trees? Lopping is cutting branches of a tree. Okay, branches, only branches. And felling entire trees means the entire tree is cut. Okay. But mostly students, for fuel wood collection, lopping is done, only the branches are cut. The forest ecosystems are repositories. Repositories means the place wherein something is stored. The forest ecosystems are repositories of some of the country's most valuable forest products, minerals and other resources that meet the demands of the rapidly expanding industrial urban economy. So try to understand, students, the forest ecosystems are the storehouse, you can say, of some of the country's most valuable forest products, minerals and other resources that meet the demands of the rapidly expanding industrial urban economy. And next is the Himalayan yew in trouble. Himalayan yew, you can see the image here, students. Himalayan yew is a medicinal plant. Okay, it's a medicinal plant found in Himachal Pradesh and Arunachal Pradesh. So this particular species, okay, it's found in Himachal Pradesh and Arunachal Pradesh. It's a medicinal plant. Okay, chemical compound called taxol is extracted from the bark, needles, twigs means thin branches, root of this tree. So chemical compound called taxol is extracted from the bark, needles, twigs, root of this tree. It's used to treat cancers. So very useful, right? Himalayan yew is used to treat cancers. It is the biggest selling anti-cancer drug in the world. The species is under great threat due to over-exploitation. Due to overuse, it's under great threat. In the last one decade, thousands of yew trees have dried up in various parts of Himachal Pradesh and Arunachal Pradesh. So in the last one decade, thousands of this kind of trees dried up, have dried up in various parts of Himachal Pradesh and Arunachal Pradesh. So I hope it's clear, students. Now let me ask you a few questions. Question number 1. Himalayan yew is found in option A, Himachal Pradesh and Arunachal Pradesh, option B, Assam, option C, Orissa, option D, none of them. Yes students, which one is the correct, which is the correct answer? Yes, option A, Himachal Pradesh and Arunachal Pradesh. Just now you have seen, right? Next question. Baksa Tiger Reserve is seriously threatened by the mining of coal. Option B, copper. Option C, dolomite. Option D, none of the above. Yes, students, which is the correct answer? Yes, option C, dolomite. Baksa Tiger Reserve is seriously threatened by the mining of dolomite. Very good. Next question. Narmada Sagar Project is in the state of Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Gujarat, Orissa. Yes, students. Once again, I'll ask you the question. Narmada Sagar Project is in the state of option A, Madhya Pradesh, option B, Maharashtra, option C, Gujarat, option D, Orissa. Yes, the correct answer is option A, Madhya Pradesh. Very good. Next, move on to the next question. Question number 4. Taxol, a chemical compound, is used to treat the patient of option A, TB, option B, cancer, option C, pneumonia, option D, fever. Yes, students, what's the correct answer? Taxol, a chemical compound, is used to treat the patient of TB, cancer, pneumonia, fever. What's the correct answer? Yes, the correct answer is option B, cancer. I hope you have understood the topics covered today, students. Let's do a short recap. We have learnt about Asiatic cheetah today. We have learnt about the reasons for the depletion of the flora and fauna. We have learnt about the Himalayan yew. Okay, I hope you will revise these topics again. Here in the slide, I'm sharing with you all a link through which you can access the video, okay, to understand the topics covered today much better. Meet you in the next video. Till then, bye and take care.